they are really going to go ahead and commit to this longer range composition. We do have the concussive blast getting eaten up by Manitin here, and currently Sharik just looking for his opportunity to jump into the back, but Nevix reinforce are already back here. They've got to be careful. Kiting back on the side of eUnited, and they've already picked up 2 kills.
Oh, they're going in so aggressively at the moment. Manitin diving in. Nevix almost got booped off right at the beginning there as well. They've effectively traded sides a little bit. The point's about to unlock. And finally, Tasha gets a pickoff onto the Genji of Nevix. So Manitin now probably going to get focused down, D-mech'd. And this is looking better and better. It looked dangerous there for a second for eUnited, but they have come out on top.
Yep, they have indeed. And so they'll take control of the point first here. It was a kind of a bit of a protracted team fight, but the Tracer's really putting in work on both sides of this field. Now, we do have Tivik here.
Over to the Soldier 76.
Alright, so yeah, definitely need that hit scan to try and deal with that far so far, but Manitin is just getting zoned out here by Sharik on that Winth, but in the backline to Vic and Nevix have already picked up 2 kills, and it looks like it's going all in favor of Misfits as they will flip over the point.
One of the issues with playing Pharah on this particular stage is that the sight lines are really long, so it's actually very difficult to play into a Soldier 76. In a lot of the more enclosed stages, or just maps in general, then the Pharah can get the better end of it, but Manitin's having a field day here.
Yeah, was able to light him up with that Helix Rocket, and now they're just going to go ahead and stall them out. They're about to tie it up currently on the control meter, as eUnited have to regroup. Valutaya is once again onto the point by himself, but last time he was here, we saw him get taken out pretty quickly by Tefik, so he's got to be careful. It's going to be Sharik starting it up with that jump in. The rocket boost is going to help them out. They've already gotten 3 kills on the side of eUnited. Xavi just trying to stall out here as Reinforce does get the knockoff onto Rubicon, looked like with that Primal Rage, but still, they haven't been able to flip over the point yet.
Yes, and Reinforces just got back in as well, so that'll just tick the timer going up a little bit more, and 50% is where it gets you before they flip. So Nevix used his Dragon Blade in that situation as well. Went in, got instantly focused down by Unfixed. The rest of his team wasn't there to support him because they were having to deal with the Nano Boosted Sharik in their backlines. But now there's a lot of ultimates up for both teams, and this is going to start equalizing soon.
All right, Reinforce is going to be the recipient of that Primal Rage. He jumps into the back, but he gets booped off, and we've got the Tactical Visor coming out from Unfixed. He hasn't found a kill quite yet. It's going to be Cruz lining them up for the most part, but there we go. Kill going over on to Manitin, and they're going to be able to retain this point. But they did commit quite a number of ultimates for that.
Yeah, both teams did, but that probably favors Misfits as they look to re-engage again. They've got the Tactical Visor. Tefik fairly close to his Pulse Bomb as well, and tends to charge it up ridiculously quickly. Farming that off Sharik, but Unfixed with the first pick onto Xavi.
Finds a second onto Tevik, and it was just a real staggered engagement coming out from Misfits at this point. The backliners jumping in one by one by one, and then immediately getting cleaned up by Unfixed there. So now 80% on the board. This could possibly be the last teamfight on this point.
They're finding it difficult to close the gap without the ability to shield themselves at all. So a lot of long-range poke damage coming in from eUnited, and Reinforce popping over to the back. Pulse bomb used, but nobody goes down. Manitin, though, taken out with the Tactical Visor.
But it already is going to be a 2-for-1 trade. The point did get flipped by Misfits for now, but eUnited is just cleaning them up at this point. Valutaya onto Xavi here. Xavi dropping real low. Valutaya does have to commit that E to get out of there. But Sharik now is the new focus of target by this Misfit squad. Nevix will be able to clean him up. And now Valutaya getting healed back up. It's Cruz back on the point, but both Genjis are now down. It is still in Misfit's favor, but with Rubicon connecting that shot onto Tevik, with the help of Valutaya, we'll clean him up. Man, Valutaya's aim is absolutely ridiculous here. He's dropping them low so quickly. They're going to have to focus around that health pack, but they're just starting to get cleaned up as that Nano Boost did come out onto Sharik. Now we've got that Tactical Visor getting popped by Unfixed here. He's already found 2 kills, but it's going to be reinforced with the Primal Raid that tries to answer back.
Instantly took down Nevix as well when he was using his Dragon Blade. Reinforce is tying them up for the moment, but that health pool is getting pushed through incredibly quickly. Down about 20 health in the back. Going to get taken up by Valutaya again, and it's 99% for both teams. But just as eUnited, are they going to be able to flip it? They had the players on the point for the moment, but in come the spawners from Misfits, and it's so close.
Yeah, it's been a real back and forth affair so far. Overtime ticking down, and we do have Sherrick jumping in at that last final moment. He did get the kill onto Zavi before finally going down to Nevix, but Nevix once again on this Genji, just getting those dash resets. He's onto Unfixed now. He should be able to get him very soon. And we see that sound barrier coming up from Morty as Cruz has gotten onto the point. He's going to be able to contest for now, but Morty does finally go down, and that's going to be Misfits taking point number one.
That was insanely close. Cruz switching over to Genji at the end, I think, was the right decision to be able to recontest the point. And he was doing a fair amount of work for the team, but as soon as the point had flipped over to Misfits and there was this big brawl, it's very difficult to get the full wipe on them when they're expending all of their ultimates just to stay alive, keep one player on the point so that their timer keeps ticking up. And eUnited got within a centimeter, a fraction of being able to flip the point over, and probably would have been in a good position to win it had they done so, but Misfits claw back into the game and hold on for the first lead.
Now we are starting to see some changeups coming out from the compositions. Looks like Reinforce is now going to go over to that Reinhardt while Mountain picks up the Zarya. Now, one of the bigger changes is Nevix going on over to this McCree on the side of Misfits.
This is pretty interesting. This is the stage that they got rolled yesterday by Laser Kittens, but it was the Sombra, and there was more of a surprise strategy in that sense. But they still looked a bit weak to the whole dive composition coming out. So Rubicon on the Zen as well. Lots of damage, lots of potential to shred Reinforce's shield.
All right, so teams just facing off from the high ground, one outside on the balcony, the other inside. We did have a sleep dart coming out, but they weren't able to follow up on it on the side of Misfits. Now Cruz in the backline has to be careful as they did commit that sound up boost to actually try and get onto him. He was able to kite away as Valetayo got the better of the exchange between him and Tevik. Now with Sharik jumping on in, it's going to be Cruz picking up the kill onto Nevix, and once again eUnited taking control of the point first, and now they're trying to get these staggered kills.
They looked like they had a really good structure there in position, Misfits, but they didn't have the shield ability to be able to push that far forward, and there's a lot of damage coming out of eUnited. That dash coming in from Cruz just put a ton of damage onto Nevix. They forced out the Viotic grenade, then they're able to pick off individual targets. Tevik didn't help by going down early on as well as Tasha puts in a lot of pressure on him.
Alright, we have Unfixed on that Soldier 76. He's got the high ground, getting free damage off for now, but the Dragon Blade, not the Dragon Blade, it's gonna be the Nana Boost coming out on the side of Misfits. It's gonna be Cruz now popping that Dragon Blade as already. It's been a 2-for-1 trade. Nevix getting the kill onto Sherrick. Reinforce will be able to clean up Cruz there. Valetaya trying his best with that Pulse Bomb to keep it alive. He's got 28 HP and a dream, but he shouldn't be long for this world as Reinforce does connect with that hammer to Vic, cleaning up Morty. We'll go ahead and allow Misfits to flip this on over, but good effort coming out from eUnited already on their first capture, already getting 48% on the board.
eUnited are a little bit unfortunate there that they didn't choose to go in a bit more aggressively and weren't able to generate their ultimates before that fight ended up petering out, because Zebesai was the only player that had to expend his ultimates, and now there's a lot to be able to hold on. The Grab Surge is going to catch them. Morty and Rubicon, that's both of the supports with their ultimates taken down. Unfix uses his tactical visor, perhaps didn't realize that that fight was already lost. And now they're in an even worse position, perhaps.
Yeah, that was a great grab coming out for Manitin there, like you had mentioned. Capturing both of the supports and allowing Reinforces to come in, swing on top of them and take them out. He even landed, connected with a great charge right on afterwards to just cement that teamfight win in. Now they are playing this choke point here. Reinforces looking for a great shatter. It's gonna come down to Sherrick and his barrier to try and make sure he doesn't connect with a huge earth shatter here.
I'd also like to point out that Valtage is doing an excellent job of tying up Tveek. Tveek's their only flanker or ability to distract them and put pressure on their backlines, and Valtage is taking him out by just forcing him to take the 1v1s.
Transcendence Engage coming out from eUnited here as the sound barrier is going to get used on the side of eUnited. Nevis already connecting onto that kill onto Valetaya. Reinforce just going for this miracle charge. Is going to quite connect, but Earth Shadow comes out. It connects on to, it looked like just Unfixed there, but Rubicon cleaning that up. And now 75% on the board for Misfits.
We've got that Nana Boost as well. Potential to use it onto Reinforce in this choke point. Possibly onto Manitin and make sure that they have a Graviton built up as well, as Manitin's already on fairly high charge. So, as eUnited look ready to engage, they've got the sound barrier as well. Morty's gonna hit that one as they come in through the choke.
Yeah, that boost going on over to Tvik here. He will be able to get that kill onto Rubicon and Morty. Both supports already down on the side of Misfits. Here comes the Graviton Surge. Cruz is caught in it. There's the Pulse Bomb, but it looked like it might not have quite connected as Cruz gets that kill onto Matson, answering right on back. And I thought this might have been a one team fight for Misfits, but eUnited fighting right on back. And now Tvik will get one final kill onto Cruz before going down. And eUnited keeping this point alive for now.
In hindsight, Misfits would have probably been far better not expecting and not expending any of the ultimates there. They're already up to 90-odd%, and if they can keep their ultimates and force them out of eUnited, then they're in a great position to recontest. Now, they've used them, they've only got the Deadeye and an Earth Shatter if Reinforce can land it, and they've got about 30 seconds.
Yeah, but already Tvik opening it up, taking out Rubicon, and they've been doing such a fantastic job on the side of Misfits of landing these kills onto the supports initially, but Tactical Visor comes out from Unfixed. He's already found one kill, but it's Nevix. Doesn't need an ultimate so far to get these kills. Two going down. It's Cruz and Sherrick already out of the equation. Great, great flashbang landing onto Valataya. That's going to allow Misfits to start cleaning up. They will flip the point 99% to 92. Zoning Deadeye coming out, but Sherrick will not be able to get on the point.
That leap just landing a little too not far enough, you know? He's about a meter away from getting onto that point, but Misfits go up 2-0. Nevix is like the silent guy in the back doing work for them, I feel. He's not flashy, he's not popping up on the kill feed that often, but he's certainly putting them off from trying to dive onto the support line of Misfits, because they can't really get within flashbang range, and he's very effective when he does take duels. So he's putting in work here on the McCree, which you don't see too often in this current meta.
But now he is swapping off onto Genji as we move on to Night Market here. And this might be the third and final point on Lijiang Towers, as currently Misfits are in great shape to finish this out for our first match of the day.
Yeah, I'm surprised so far that eUnited haven't been able to get a slightly better grip on a lot of these team fights. But Misfits are doing a great job fending them off. Reinforce goes down immediately though as Nevix dives into the back line. And Nevix and Tweak popping off right now, getting a clutch of kills between them. They're just too strong. They're out muscling them.
Yeah, they just had the initiative there. They jumped onto them first and coordinated their attack really well there, getting into the back line. A lot of them were bundled up on the side of eUnited, so once Reinforce jumped in with his shift, they just landed so much damage. Of course, Nevix with the Swift Strike resets, just really dishing out the damage. Finds that kill onto Unfixed, but it's Cruz. The back line, reset after reset. That's his third kill. Nevix trying to answer on back, but it's all Cruz for eUnited right now.
They're going to be able to get on the point here as well, though, for eUnited. There's only one player really delaying them. That's Nevix. 24% is what Misfits start out on, and they've just about got the Pulse Bomb, but no other ults online. It's the same situation over on eUnited though, so this is going to be another perhaps a slow push as people generate ultimates and then engage with those.
Alright, Tvik is sitting on that Pulse Bomb right now, trying to find his opening in. He hasn't gotten spotted out quite yet. Unfixed is able to actually dodge that Pulse Bomb. Kind of got stuck in a little bit of a corner there, but Valataya goes for a Pulse Bomb of his own. He's already gotten a kill onto Reinforce, wasn't able to stick it either. But with that Orb of Discord, finishing off Zabe, no problem. Now he's on the hunt for more. Actually has to back away as he does get anti-healed there.
In general, Zebesai has also been able to stay alive much more than we saw previously from him when he's been playing Ana in these triple DPS comps, and he's been reasonably untouched by eUnited, which is surprising because they're normally very good at picking off individual targets, but at the moment, I think the DPS players and Reinforce are putting them under so much pressure that they feel like they have to deal with them first.
Alright, they do get spotted out on the high ground on the side of eUnited here. Cruz is just sitting on that blade, just looking for his opportunity, but it's going to be Falutaya opening it up, getting that frag onto Tvik. Now Mantis is going to push forward with that tactical visor, but Transcendence is going to heal everyone up as Cruz pushes forward. He's got that Dragon Blade, that's a second kill for him. And they're going to be able to just maintain control over this point right now. Misfits finding it very difficult to try and get this point on back. Zave with a very late kill too.
Sharik and Cruz up there with Volataja on the high ground, making sure that they can spot them out wherever they end up going. They have the sound barrier to work with as well, as they're up into the 90% already. Primal Rage, Dragon Blade, Pulse Bomb all up for Misfits as they take the flank around the right-hand side.
Yeah, as we go on over to Nevix, he is already on the backline onto Rubicon, but unfortunately he wasn't able to just get that combo kill coming on out. It just came a little bit too slow. We do have the Primal Rage getting used by Reinforce right now. Try and keep this point alive. It's at 99%. We're in overtime here, but he's getting focused down immediately. And it looks like eUnited are starting to wake up here. Well, it's already, what, about 6, 7 o'clock over there?
Just waking up, though. You know.
Just waking up, though. This is esports time.
They've had a siesta.
Esports schedule.
Yeah, definitely. They play well into the latest night, and then they wake up at about 6 p.m. That seems reasonable.
All right. And so now, eUnited keeping this alive as we are going to go back on to Garden here. Last time we did see them opening up with the Pharah, but I believe they had swapped off to try and go hit scan to deal with the Pharah. Nevix swapped off, I believe.
Oh, Manitin went to Soldier 76. He started on D.Va as they are at the moment, and then he went over to Soldier 76, basically after the first fight. So, interesting that he's starting again on D.Va. They want to execute the strategy that they have, but they're going to be expecting the same composition coming out here from Unfix and Fruz.
All right, so the Far getting spot out and opening up just like we had before. It is going to be Reinforced getting to the back line, immediately getting cleaned up by Unfix, though Nevix trying his best to answer right on back. That's a double kill for him, but eUnited now to be outdone. They've already picked up 3 kills here. They got the D-Mech too.
Speak manages to pick up the kill there as the rest of Sharik eUnited getting onto the point. Reinforce and Tweak still around. Tweak's doing very low though.
Yeah, he is, and Cruz has to back off there using the Concussive Blast to disengage, but they are getting forced off the point. So eUnited looking like they will be able to take it. Zave just here trying to delay. We even got Tevik on the point. I don't know why they're trying to delay at this point. Teamfight largely won on the side of eUnited already.
The Pharah is working out well for them as well. And I think Manitin is now switching over to the Soldier 76. The reason he's probably starting out on D.Va every time is just so that he can eat the Concussive Blast as they go over the bridge. If he starts on the Soldier 76 and they have to play passively, they probably give up too much ground straight off the bat. So he needs to eat that so that they can move forwards.
All right, so Cruz tried to go for that barrage, but Nevix was able to just deflect it all back into it right now. Pulse Bomb coming out. Zebesai will be able to dodge it for now, but Sharik with that Primal Rage jumps right on top of him. We'll clean that up. Pulse Bomb comes out from Tevik, but it doesn't connect either. Now it's all Sharik with this Primal Rage, just keeping the point for eUnited.
Nano Boost almost up for Zebesai here. It's going to be synced up with Nevix's Dragon Blade as well, so definite potential for them to send in a Nano Blade and see if they can get damage onto a lot of these backline. That's what they're going to do as Reinforce jumps into the back as well. Nevix hasn't quite got onto any of them yet. Forced to use his Deflect and back off towards the point. Almost completely wasted, and in the other side, all of the aggression coming out from eUnited into the Misfits backline, and they're picking up kill after kill.
Yeah, primarily Zave here. I believe that was his fourth kill in this team fight. He started it off with the boop and then just getting that kill onto Manitin, I believe. Finally does get cleaned up by Cruz. Misfits were able to get 11 points on the board there. Things looked actually a bit more dire from my point of view when initially I was watching Nevix go in, but he had to use both dashes just to try and close the gap, and then from there he got largely kited. But they were able to clean up off the heroics of Zave. Though, now we do have them moving into the backline again. Volatayek, nice two-man pulse bomb coming out here. We do have that nano boost on to Unfix there. They're going to go ahead and force back Misfits once again.
I think, in general, the triple DPS composition where Unfix is playing the Soldier 76 and Cruz is over on Genji makes more sense on this particular stage. The Pharah can work and puts a lot of pressure on them, but they play the best when they have Cruz and Valitaja off on these heroes.
Dragon Blade comes out along with that sound barrier. Rubicon with the two-man Biotic Nade. We'll finish off to Vic and Zave. Reinforced is trying his best to keep this alive, but he's already down to no health. Does get cleaned up and looks like we're going to get tied up here on Lijiang.
Brilliant play coming out from eUnited. They're able to claw their way back from the 2-0 deficit. They were really competitive in the first and to a large extent the second round as well, and now they've shown that they're really coming out to play, as you say, waking up. But for Misfits, they're gonna be thinking about where it's all gone wrong. The 2-0 lead, and now they're on the bad end of a reverse sweep. And this stage previously was good for them, but it required a lot of cohesion, and there was certainly the ability for it to go wrong. So this is going to be a tense final stage for both teams.
Yep, the reverse sweep currently coming out from eUnited, but I might have just cursed them. We'll see, as once again, Nevix will be on that McCree, which he did pull out on the onset of this map, and to great effect for the most part. He was shutting down Volataya pretty well with that flashbang. So now the team's just about to meet up in the middle here.
Both Tracers taking the duel. Valentasha forced to use his recall as, again, Misfits post up on the top of the staircase. Is the rest of eUnited just wait for the point to unlock or wait for an individual player to poke their head off and take that single pick? It's going to be Tveek. That happened again last time. The exact same time on Control Center, Tveek was the first pick, and then they were able to get some good dash resets through everybody and take the damage. This time, Misfits just going to make sure that they keep everybody together, consolidate before they attack again.
Yeah, less of an explosive start to this map here, but once again, reUnited is up top, just getting free damage off. Got that first kill onto Zebesai. Now on the ground, Reinforce dropping real low. He is able to swing onto Sherrick and take him out, but Cruz is going to be able to finish him off with that Swift Strike.
That's a real dangerous position for Unfix to be in as well, because there's nobody that can contest him. Now they switch Nevix over to the Genji, potentially aware that Nevix... they're not going to go for a dive straight onto him with Cruz and Valitasha. eUnited playing it much more passively because they realized that McCree was there and they have the more tanky setup. And now they want to do some diving of their own, contest the high ground with Nevix.
All right, and so no ultimates quite yet on the board. 42% in favor of eUnited. They're just 60 away from being able to finish this off. Cruz backs off just a little bit, has to pick up the health pack because he did get tagged by the Ana twice there. But now Zebesai, the first person to go down, but already we've got Misfits answering back. That's going to be a 2-for-1 as Zave and Tveek find two kills of their own. Great sleep dart onto Zave, and unfortunately, Cruz was not able to connect with that Dragon Blade, though. He comes in with that dash resets, finally finishes off Zave here, but Reinforce will be swinging on him, takes him out. Reinforce dropping low, though, will go down. Now it's all down to Nevix and Tveek here as the DPS duo so far. Nevix does pick up that health pack, but he's getting focused down by Sharik, and he will be able to finish him off with that Tesla cannon.
Because both teams were playing so passively at the beginning, and they allowed eUnited to get the point, and then Nevix switched hero as well, they're only now just getting their ultimates online, and it's at 90% for eUnited in the final round of Lijiang Tower. This is a disastrous situation. They have to be able to take the point here, Misfits, and they have to be able to hold on with their ultimate economy. Real tough mountain to climb.
Now we do have that nanovisor getting used by Unfix. He's up top, got one kill onto Zave as Volataya has already taken out Zebesai, and it looks like eUnited have just done it. It's gonna be the reverse sweep as overtime is ticking down. Reinforce not even able to get his hammer down there. Great job, eUnited, really staying in this match even though they started off with that 2-0 deficit.
A really nice adaptation throughout the map on triple DPS, and they're going to begin on attack anyway. So useless information to begin, Jameson.
Nevix starting off once again. We saw him on that McCree on King's Row attack first. I don't believe he actually picked. He decided to use that on defense though. So a
he did use
bit
it on attack as well.
No, I don't believe he used it on defense. Did he?
I can't remember actually, but he has been favoring it quite a bit. He was playing it into the Reinhardt though, whereas they're going to be playing it into a dive comp. Who knows?
All right, so on the side of eUnited, it looks like they are going to be going for that triple DPS dive composition. Once again, Rubicon just getting that Sonic Arrow off with the Hanzo before it swaps off to the Zenyatta, and now it's gonna come down to Nevix to try and shut down Unfix. He does tag him a few times, but he's at that damage drop-off range where he's not really able to make that damage stick. He does land a headshot onto Cruz, making him really tentative to try and jump in, but they're still looking for their window of opportunity on the side of eUnited.
Taking both of the Genjis up top now as they fight in the corridor, but Cruz has got a bit of position up there, has to use his deflect. That's offline, but barrier shattered as well for Reinforce as they go for a wrap around the house. Sharik immediately taken out. Unfix needs to be dealt with next.
Ooh, Nevix dropping real low. Nice, great sleep dart coming out to be able to finish off Volataya there. And Misfits are going to be able to hold on for now on that first point. And Tevik starting to get reset after reset. So, great first hold coming up for Misfits.
eUnited, when they previously played Misfits, got kind of a lucky first offense where they were able to crack the point A within about 30 seconds because Unfixed hit some ungodly rockets onto the defending Ana. So hopefully that won't happen again. Zebesai may be slightly more aware of that, looking not to catch the long-range directs.
Dragonblade coming out from Tevik. He does get a little bit of a late nano boost there, but he's already gotten two kills. He's going to force Sherrick back, and he should be able to clean him up. There we go. Nice headshot with the shurikens. That's going to be eUnited holding on. And they're going to be able to buy a lot of time because Nevix also has that high noon, that Deadeye in his pocket to buy time for Manitin to try and get that Graviton Surge.
This is also dangerous for eUnited because Misfits, previously when they played King's Row, kind of got rolled on the beginning portion of the map, but then were excellent at the end when it came to the Foundry. So if you allow them time to defend at this first point, and they're also going to be excellent at the end, eUnited going to find it really difficult to beat the Quark. Now the Transcendence coming in. Biotic Grenade keeps everybody on Misfits really healthy. Cruz uses his Dragon Blade as a Graviton comes out as well, but doesn't really catch that many people. They've all died though, and it's only Unfixed left alive with his ultimate trying to get out of there. And Valitash is still kicking around as well.
Oh, yeah, here comes the barrage, but Tevik just able to clean that up real quickly. And wow, a lot committed on the side of eUnited there. Possibly thinking of swap off? Yeah, so Unfixed is going to go ahead and pick up that Soldier 76 after committing that barrage there.
He's going to be looking to loop around the top right, probably contest from behind. If he can get into the window up on the corridor up top, then he's in a good position to force a bit of a squeeze play onto Misfits. Force them into Hotel instead, they get free reign on the point, and now they've got that position for the Graviton Surge and the Sound Barrier.
Yeah, the Earth Shatter was committed there from Reinforce. That allows them to pick up two kills. It's going to be a 2-for-2 trade. Sharik is going to go ahead and use that Primal Rage. Unfixed gets taken out, but it's going to be Valutaya cleaning up here. Now it looks like eUnited's finally done it, breaking the defense on the side of Misfits.
That was close as well, because that Earth Shatter that came out caught quite a number of people, and I thought they would be able to finish up those kills, but not quite the damage to be able to capitalize on Reinforce's nice ultimate. Cruz has been slept in the street stage, though. Zebesai just waiting. Whoa, Zebesai gets picked! Was that that must have been an orb to the face there as Zebesai goes down. That's actually disastrous for them. That can start a snowball going.
Yeah, you really do have to be careful here, especially now with that Ana out. But Tevik getting that kill onto Valutaya does make this offense a little bit more fragile. And so we're seeing them just holding on to the point. They're going to be having three people on the payload now instead of trying to take this really aggressive hold that you normally try to do with that triple DPS composition, just holding right outside of the Foundry.
Nevix running the McCree here as well is pretty decent in the streets phase. Everybody that he fights is going to be within his flashbang range. Feek's taking the Nanoblade though, and he's going to town on everybody. That's gonna be a fight lost from eUnited for sure, as Misfits able to stabilize in the streets, and the cart really hasn't made that much progress yet.
No, it has not, and still Manitin's here is sitting on this Graviton Surge. He did get caught a little bit out there in the last team fight as he tried to fall back to keep Zebesai alive, but unfortunately right before Sherrick had jumped in, he had committed his projected barrier on out. But now Valutaya in the back line, he's got that pulse bomb at the ready and he's trying to spot out the support. The Graviton Surge did come out, and here comes a Deadeye, but great barrier coming out on the side of Sherrick is going to allow Cruz to come on in, clean him up. That's a second kill coming up from him. He's starting to get those resets. That's a triple kill for him as he tries to get that final one onto Zebesai, but it's going to be Morty with that alternative fire. That does finish him off. Now the payload finally making some good headway here. I don't think they're going to be able to contest on the side of Misfits.
Not before it reaches the checkpoint for sure, especially with these eUnited players pushed up.
Now, Sherrick does give his body for that play, but the respawn distance fairly close here, so it's okay to give that away as long as you secure that checkpoint. And they have, so now the defense, they are in a pretty good position. No ultimates really on the side of eUnited as Reinforced is just holding that front line. He's got that Earth Shatter at the ready.
This was where Misfits were so deadly before. Their ult economy was absolutely fantastic when they were holding this particular region. And they were putting a lot of resources onto Tweak. Previously, though, they were playing with Azaria so that he had to bubble every time he went in. is not something they have currently. They've got Manatin to try and dive in and apply pressure with him. But in they go with this Dragon Blade, and that's where the Zarya bubble's gonna help, because Tweaks immediately put to sleep.
Yeah, but they were able to get that kill onto Morty by Reinforce there, and Tevik stays alive for now, drops a little bit low, but he's able to dash on out. Reinforce is still sitting on this Earth Shatter here, so eUnited have to be very cautious as they push forward.
They do. Rubicon on the Ana, gonna be fairly close to his Nano Boost. At the same time as Morty ticks up onto the Sound Barrier, so they're up for both teams. And if he can get some way of engaging with the rest of the team, that Earth Shatter's gonna catch so many of them. Morty and Sharik on the floor, debuffed as well. Sound Barrier popped down for both teams, keeps them somewhat alive, but they're still fairly weak.
Yeah, Manatin is gonna go ahead and commit that Primal Rage right now as Tevik got that dash reset, getting that kill, but second kill going on over to Rubicon might have just put a stop to this offense. They've only got a minute and 15 seconds left. They got to regroup here. Valutaya trying his best to take out Manatins. Manatins will be able to actually just squeak on by there through that window, get back to Zebesai. Now the ultimate advantage going in favor of eUnited at this point. As unfortunately in that last team fight, Reinforce, even though he hit a great shatter, Morty had an even better sound barrier.
Battle of the Nano Blades at the moment as they're both out. Cruz and Tweak, who can get the better end of it? Tweak with two already. Cruz can't find anything with his, unfortunately, immediately put to bed. And I don't understand how the Misfits backline was able to survive there, but Cruz got nothing with it. That's a massive swing in momentum with only 30 seconds left as well.
Yeah, all they used was that Nano Blade, and so now they're going to have the Graviton, they're going to have the Earth Shatter along with that Tactical Visor, and these are highly impactful ultimates coming out on the side of eUnited as they push forward, and all they've got to answer is this Deadeye coming out from Nevix, but no real damage going on over to Sherrick's shield there, so they're not going to be able to break it. Madison was able to get that kill onto Rubicon, though. Now they are starting to clean up here from the defense. 5 seconds left. It's about to go into overtime. Nevix not able to quite connect with that Earth Shatter. Unfixed will be able to get the kill onto Madison, but now they're starting to get cleaned up on the side of eUnited. Reinforced just getting free swings off. Morty trying his best to contest, and now overtime ticking on out. Nevix completing that kill onto Rubicon. They'll finally put a stop to eUnited here. And 26.93 meters, that's all they were able to push here as they got into the boundary portion.
Yeah, it was pretty much the same last time when they played against Laser Kittens. Their defense in that first stage of Foundry is something that they seem to have practiced repeatedly and are excellent at. They know exactly how to use their ultimates for maximum value. They know how to outplay enemy ultimates as they're coming in as well. You saw that particularly when the Graviton Surge came in. Nevix uses his zoning Deadeye perfectly, and a Biotic Grenade put onto Reinforce as he just holds his shield up. Make sure that nobody on the enemy team can actually engage Reinforce or dive behind the shield, because Sharik has to hold his up to block the Deadeye from killing them all. So great coordination. Then Tweak is just a monster with the Nano Blades, it seems, every single time, getting the better end of Cruz. And Misfits once again holding the Foundry.
All right, so now it's going to be Misfits' opportunity to attack here. On the side of eUnited, though, it looks like they're going to go for that 2-2-2 defensive composition once again. Cruz and Valutaya playing those backline DPS heroes, while Unfixed will be picking up that Zarya, and Shark is going to be relegated to square or rectangle duty on that Reinhardt. Now, there's still plenty of time for Misfits to finalize their composition before they get out of the gates. To Vic, I think he's just going to go for, you know, it's just some Hail Mary shots with that Hanzo before he swaps on over to probably Genji.
Yeah, this doesn't look like a very realistic composition for the offense, gotta say. But it's interesting to note as well that a lot of the better teams in Europe are running with these more tanky compositions on the first point defense and then moving back to the triple DPS to defend in the streets phase and stuff. Whereas Rogue and quite a number of the slightly lower level teams in Europe have just worked on defending with triple DPS, and Rogue in particular are fantastic at it, so it's definitely viable.
Alright, so Nevix once again on this cowboy. They're starting to push over. They do have control over this statue. No one really on the high ground, so they spot that out and they're not going to try and wrap around. Now they do push forward. Tevik has swapped off to this Genji, so from one Shimada to the next, and it's going to be reinforced with a great charge onto Rubicon, but Valutaya in the back starting to clean up with the help of Cruz.
I thought that was going to be the perfect rat play there as Manatin came in from behind, dropped down behind the arch and sandwiched them in. The aggression came out of Misfits and Manatin was there getting full cleave damage onto everybody, but the DPS is coming out way too strong as Cruz and Valutasha shred through everybody, end up with all of the kills.
Alright, currently Sherrick with a great ultimate advantage. He's at 62% along with Unfix, so they're about to get these tank ultimates up rather soon. Cruz has almost got his Dragonblade too.
Manatin up top in the window looking for this rat play again, I think. Gonna drop down as the aggression comes in for the rest of Misfits. Now he drops, jumping onto the back line as well, seeing if they can focus down the Ana. But they do find the early kills, but things are still fairly even, and Cruz has used his Dragonblade, getting a lot of value out of that. 3 kills for him.
Yeah, taking out both supports there. They're going to go ahead and put a stop to this offense for now. 2 minutes and 30 seconds still left on the side for Misfits, and now they are starting to build up towards their ultimates. But on the side of eUnited, take a look at that. They've got the Earth Shatter. They're going to have that Graviton along with the Nano Boost. Such high impactful ultimates coming out inside of eUnited right now. Cruz does have to be careful, though. He's getting focused down by Manitou. It's going to be Nevix that connects with that kill.
Pulse Bomb used inside of the Graviton and everybody from Misfits gonna fall in. Valutasha picks up 2 kills immediately and then Reinforce and Manatin have a lot of damage put onto them. That's gonna signal the retreat. Tweak put to sleep as well. What a stagger. He was so weak as well. Just gonna get slapped in the face by Rubicon to finish.
Yeah, during that time, Valutasha almost got the kill onto Zave, basically over by that bus. But yeah, great stall coming out on the side of eUnited at this point. But now, things are looking better and better for Misfits as they are working up to 5 ultimates now. Zave about 5% out from that Sound Bear. They're going to have that Nano Blade up.
Nano Blade used in Earth Shatter as well. Catches Sharrick, who'd had the Nano Boost used onto him. He's been debuffed. Can they finish him? Oh, trades with Reinforce in terms of charges. And Manitin's going to use his Primal Rage as well. So much health coming out from them. But Zebesai and Nevix have already fallen. There goes Reinforce. Cruz coming back in. And it looks like still eUnited able to hold on.
Yeah, Morty's sound barrier timings have been almost impeccable this entire matchup. Now Zave does clean up Rubicon there. We also saw a Sleep Dart coming out from Rubicon actually to shut down Tevik with that Nano Blade. So a lot of crucial plays coming out from all ends of eUnited at this point as Cruz does have to be careful. He's got that Biotic Nade, that debuff onto him right now. Morty does finally get that kill onto Manitin. It's a 1-for-1 trade as Valutasha did go down. Charge comes on out. Neo Ryan's quite landing. Cruz is going to be in the back line. He's got that Dragon Blade. That's a 2-for-1 deal coming out for him as Reinforce does trade on back, but it's not going to be quite enough. Misfits has to regroup here. It's coming down to their final push.
They're in dire straits at the moment. 30 seconds, they'll have a Nano Blade up, but Unfix has to be their target. I think they haven't really been choosing the Zarya to dive on. A lot of the time, it is a viable dive target if you can manage to work your way in. But Unfix has the Graviton up as well, and if that goes into them, if we manage to use it aggressively, and Zebesai gets caught in it, gonna die instantly there. And Tweak not able to use the Dragon Blade at the same time. Oh, he's just gonna get the end of it.
But then he gets shattered. Oh man, great hold coming up from eUnited here up against Misfits, and now it looks like it's going to be the 2-0 as overtime is ticking on down. eUnited going to be moving on to our upper bracket finals, knocking Misfits down to our lower bracket.
Unreal. We thought it was going to be a blinder of a match, and that was a fantastic finish for it. eUnited take it 2-0. That's potentially unexpected, but they did go to 2 of eUnited's best maps, I think, just by part luck, part decision, and eUnited bossing them with that first point defense. Perhaps they should have tried Nevix on a different DPS, like halfway through that push. He stayed on McCree for a long time.
Very long time there. And he tried his best to deal with the pressure that was getting put out by those backline dive characters, but unfortunately there was just way too much pressure. So now, that is our first match. That was our postponed match from yesterday. And out of the way, we're moving on to the